Greetings. I believe we have met before. I am, of course, your workforce, your employee, your sales floor, your development team. I am your subordinate, your marketer, your assistant, your follower. I am the next generation and you are the former. I am the next iteration and you are the older. I am the one or the many placed under your responsibility. And I don't know why, but you keep on trying to manage me. For you can manage anything. Your financial portfolio, your social schedule, your meeting minutes, your spending limits. You can manage your time and manage your anger. You can manage your corporate climb and manage your behavior. You can manage nearly anything for which you could put pen to paper. Yet, the one thing you most often try to manage through hours of training and decades of labor is the one thing no manager or management could ever manage before and has never managed since, and that is the unmanageable power of the human spirit. You can't manage it. Not ideas nor progress, not ideals nor success. There is no management for people or their minds, not for humanity or their lives. You will never administrate the creative or incorporate the innovative. You can't regulate progression or incarcerate momentum. For when you try to manage a human, you make them inhuman. For it is only in humans that we have this infusion of endless creativities and the freedoms to use them. So, if it is leadership you don't just want to be in, but want to succeed in, don't try to manage people. Instead, you must lead them. You see, managers regulate, but leaders liberate. Managers stipulate, but leaders simulate. Managers isolate, but leaders collaborate. Leaders get devotion. Managers just get promotions. Leaders make us conquerors. Managers just make their numbers. Leaders look out for the commonwealth. Managers are just looking out for themselves. So, if you keep on insisting on letting your title do your talking, instead of letting your integrity be your calling, you will manage to be a dead leader walking. If you keep up all this progression stifling and talent blocking, you will manage to be a dead leader walking. If you keep on hoarding the key that's doing all this future locking, you will manage to be a dead leader walking. If you're not shaping minds but still punching and clocking, if you're only looking out for yourself and not guiding and cautioning, if you're playing it safe and avoiding the shocking, you have already managed to become a dead leader walking. And that is all you'll be managing when you try to manage the living. For those with breath in their lungs and hearts in their chest aren't waiting to be managed. We are waiting to be led. So, if you want to lead me, don't try to manage me. Instead, show me your authenticity. Show me that you authentically care about my identity. Give a platform to my creativity. Creatively guide me down the paths with which you already have familiarity. Become familiar with my dreams, my goals, and my story. Go out before me. Set the pace you want me to be keeping. Set the tone you want me to be singing. Set the goals you want me to be reaching. But don't just tell me to do it. Demonstrate it with every ounce of your being. Then you are being the leader I need. For you have started to lead my heart instead of manage my head. So, to all of you in the management ranks of the undead, I beckon you, come back to life and live to lead, or you will manage nothing but what is already.